next one, this is now not in competition with my cab, nor here now. This is Owto.
Okay. Yes.
And we're with Paolo. Paolo, no accreditation just yet.
Yes, right now we're still waiting for the accreditation from the board of LTIFRB, but we're very confident that we might get it anytime within the next 2 weeks, probably. And the last thing that they actually wanted to check with us is our fare matrix. Yeah. And that was done last week, Thursday. And I believe these guys, these gentlemen right here were also with us last week. And that was the main discussion that we had. No? All the requirements were already submitted to the to LTIFRB. So right now, we're just waiting for the board members to, you know, approve the fare matrix that we submitted to them.
Tell us more about Owto.
Okay, Owto was.
Is it Owto?
It's supposed to be Owto. Yeah.
Okay.
it's some kind of wordplay.
Okay, how? Automobile.
Yeah, automobile.
And.
And then there's it's like here. Medyo fancy.
Sige.
In a way. So it was supposed to be Owto. More like a, because our main target also are the millennials as well, so just like here now. So we wanted to make it like OH, but then there's a similar name already, so that's why we opted for OWTO.
So ang tama palang pronunciation niya, Owto.
Owto.
Tama ko, Owto. Okay,
yeah.
Alright.
And well, Owto was actually a concept by me, because I was a former TNVS driver for more than a year. Yeah, and I was going in back and forth to the, with the two TNCs way back, and there was a very big gap that was actually needed, where a solution was needed, and I made some fortunate, like, interviews with a couple of my co-drivers within both companies, and I saw that there was something that we could actually
improve.
Yeah. On the current situation. So I talked to a few friends, they actually saw the potential of the business, and yeah, that's why we're here right now.
What needs to be improved? What did you see that needs improvement?
Okay. Number one, there are a lot of driver concerns that I actually heard from my co-drivers. So, and because of that, you know, we know that grabbing Uber are actually foreign companies to start off with, so they actually had to grasp the market so that they can provide for our drivers adequately. But from our end, because our team is all Filipino, we were able to actually come up with ways and solution that our drivers right now here in the Philippines can actually be provided for, like their safety at night, just like what Grab has told us earlier, compensation.
So improved. Improved,
yeah,
security and compensation for the drivers.
Exactly.
And what about the customers also?
Of course, for the riders. So we're trying to strike a balance between the, the riders and the drivers. Because, of course, as you may know, the TNC's clients are both the riders and the drivers.
True.
So it's not only for the drivers that we actually have to do something, but for the riders as well. Right now, our overall focus is on the riding experience, which is actually having a very big impact in the ride-sharing industry here in the Philippines right now, because, you know, riders are willing to pay. Riders are willing to pay in general, but them experiencing a very bad treatment from the partners overall is actually preventing them from enjoying the full potential of the ride sharing concept.
All right, we'll be talking about the fare matrix. Do they have a destination in their app? And of course, ensuring safety with our guests from Hirna, MyCab, and Owto.